Hi, I'm Dr. Robin, aka Double O Pi. In the previous video on fractional composition of a monoprotic acid, I explained what fractional composition was and how you calculate it for a monoprotic acid. In this video, we're going to tackle the same sort of calculation for a diprotic acid. Pretty much everything we did in the previous video, we could at least approximate with an ice table. The stuff we're diving into in this video is a little more complicated to calculate, and this is where using fractional composition becomes a huge advantage. Let's start out by reviewing diprotic acid equilibria. A diprotic acid is one that has two different hydrogens that can dissociate. So we have three possible species in solution. A fully protonated acid, an anion that's lost one proton, and an anion that's lost two protons. Another way to think about this is to consider what happens when you put a whole bunch of diprotic acid molecules into solution. Some of them will lose both acidic protons, some of them will only lose one acidic proton, and some of them will not lose any protons at all. Remember that the definition of fractional composition is what fraction of the total acid that the species you're looking at comprises. A diprotic acid can be in the H2A form, the HA minus form, or the A2 minus form. So the total amount of acid present in solution, which we write like this, will be the amount you have of each of those three species. Once again, a reminder that we're doing this accounting by molarity. Because a diprotic acid can form three possible species, we can calculate three different fractional compositions for H2A, HA minus, and A2 minus. The fractional composition for H2A, alpha sub H2A, will be the concentration of H2A divided by the total concentration of the acid. We can write similar expressions for the other two species. Don't forget that we also have an expression for the total amount of acid, and we can substitute this into the expressions we just wrote. As with monoprotic acids, if we add the fractional composition of each of our three solution components, we get three fractions that can be combined into a single fraction, and the simplified total of these fractions equals one. Again, that will always be true of your fractional compositions. But what we really want to do with diprotic acids is create the same sort of pH-dependent fractional composition expressions that we did for monoprotic acids. To do that, we need to remember that each of those protons that could dissociate has its own associated equilibrium constant. So we have two acid dissociation constant expressions that we can use for this purpose. We're going to start with our expression for Ka2, the second acid dissociation constant. And what we're going to do here is solve for the concentration of HA as a function of everything else. To do that, we'll multiply both sides by the concentration of HA minus and divide both sides by Ka2. If we do that, we see that the concentration of HA minus equals the concentration of H plus times the concentration of A2 minus divided by Ka2. Now we're going to take our expression for the first acid dissociation constant, Ka1. And we're going to take this expression that we just derived for the HA concentration and plug it in. At first we get something that looks really awkward, but if you simplify it, you get this. Ka1 equals H plus squared times A2 minus divided by Ka2 times H2A. So again, here's that expression that we just derived, and we're going to play with it just a bit more because we want to solve for the concentration of H2A. We'll do that by multiplying both sides by the concentration of H2A and dividing by Ka1, and we're left with this. Here are the two expressions we derived, one for H2A and one for HA minus. And now we're going to bring back our expression for the total amount of acid in the system. See how it's got H2A and HA minus concentrations? We're going to substitute these expressions into that. And we get this expression. Note that each term has an A2 minus concentration. Let's factor that out. Now we're ready to start calculating fractional composition. I'm going to start with H2A. Remember that this is how our fractional composition is defined. At this point, we have expressions that we can substitute in for both the H2A concentration and the total amount of acid. So let's do that. We get a real mess. So let's take that mess we just derived and simplify it a bit. And the way we're going to do that is by multiplying both top and bottom by Ka1 and Ka2. That's easy math for the numerator because both Ka1 and Ka2 cancel out. But in the denominator, you have to distribute this through every term in the parentheses. In the first term, both Ka1 and Ka2 cancel. In the second term, only Ka2 cancels. And in the third term, nothing cancels. So we get this. We can simplify this further by canceling out the A2 minus concentrations in both the numerator and denominator. Now we have a fractional composition expression that is only in terms of the H plus composition and our two acid dissociation constants. We'll follow the same procedure for the fractional composition of HA minus. Again, we start with a definition and plug in our derived expressions, giving us a messy fraction that contains fractions. So again, we're going to simplify by canceling out the A2 minus concentrations in both numerator and denominator. And we're also going to get rid of the fractions within a fraction by multiplying both top and bottom by Ka1 and Ka2. When you do that, you get this expression. And of course, we could do similar math for A2 minus. This one is a lot easier because we only have A2 minus on the top, not a whole expression. But we still go ahead and cancel the A2 minus concentrations and get rid of the fraction within a fraction by multiplying top and bottom by Ka1 times Ka2, and we get this. So now we have the fractional composition expressions for each of the three species in a diprotic acid solution. As you look at them, you'll notice a couple of things. First of all, the denominators are the same. Please remember that the denominator represents the total amount of acid, so this is a good thing. Secondly, if you look at the numerators of each fraction, you see that they each correspond to a term in the denominator. H plus squared represents the H2A fraction, Ka1 times H plus represents the HA minus fraction, and Ka1 times Ka2 represents the A2 minus fraction. So the total of these fractions would be H plus squared plus Ka1 times H plus Ka1 times Ka2, and that represents the total amount of acid available, which is the denominator of our fraction. If you took Gen Chem with me, you learned a bit about diprotic acid equilibria. Basically, we calculated things by making assumptions, but there was a caveat to those assumptions, namely that they only worked if the Ka1 and Ka2 were several orders of magnitude apart. But that's not always true with a diprotic acid. When I'm creating diprotic acid problems in Gen Chem, I have to be very careful which acids I pick, because not all diprotic acids fit the bill. And of course, we assume that there's nothing else in solution, that the pH is 100% a function of the diprotic acid concentration, which may not always be the case. By contrast, we can use the fractional composition approach for any sort of diprotic acid at any sort of pH. Let's take these expressions that we derived for fractional composition and apply it to an actual diprotic acid, butane dioic acid, also called succinic acid. I put the pKa's here. You can see that they're pretty close in magnitude. Let's use this information to calculate the fractional composition at a couple of different pHs, pH 2.70 and pH 4.80. At pH 2.7, our H plus concentration will be 10 to the minus 2.7. We can use our pKa data to determine that Ka1 will be 10 to the minus 4.21 and Ka2 will be 10 to the minus 5.64. Now let's plug those into our fractional composition expressions. You can see how I've done that here for the fractional composition of H2A. Note that I could have put 6.17 times 10 to the minus 5th instead of 10 to the minus 4.21 for Ka1, but I find it a lot easier to do this way. If you plug this into your calculator, you get 0.97. We can do similar calculations for HA minus and A2 minus. These tell us that the fractional composition for HA minus is 0.03 and A2 minus is 3.4 times 10 to the minus 5th. In other words, at pH 2.7, you have mostly undissociated succinic acid, a small amount of singly deprotonated succinic acid, and very little of the doubly deprotonated anion. Let's see how this changes if we adjust the pH of the solution to 4.8. Under these conditions, our H plus concentration will be 10 to the minus 4.8. We still have the same Ka values, of course. So let's plug this info into our fractional composition expressions. I put too many sig figs on these, but I'm pretty sure someone would have squawked about them not adding up to one if I didn't. That's because of rounding. Technically, I should report these as 0.18, 0.71, and 0.1. As you can see, changing the pH to 4.8 means we mostly have the HA minus form, but we still have a reasonable amount of the other two species. If you compare the fractional compositions at the two pHs, you can see that by moving to a more basic pH, you end up with a lot less of the protonated acid form, a lot more of the singly deprotonated conjugate base, and a little bit more of the doubly deprotonated conjugate base. Is there a pH at which you have mostly A2 minus? Let's do a graph to find out. Again, I'm using Excel to make my graph. I've got the values for Ka1 and Ka2 here in cells G4 and G9. Once again, I've put in a range of pHs from 0 to 14 in column A, and I've used these pHs to calculate the H plus concentration in column B. So now I'm going to put in the formula for H2A into cell C2. The formula for HA minus into cell D2, and the formula for A2 minus into cell E2. And now I'm going to cut and paste these all the way down. Once again, let's do a quick check by looking at what we got for one of the pHs we calculated by hand. That looks right. Now let's look at the graph. As with monoprotic acids, the pKa's tell us where we transition between predominant species. When the pH equals pKa1 or 4.21, we've basically got 50% H2A and 50% HA-. When our pH is lower than this, we mostly have H2A. In other words, that's the predominant species in solution. When the pH is higher than that, we have more HA-. When the pH equals pKa2 or 5.64, we've got 50% HA- and 50% A2-. When the pH is just below that point, we have more HA-, and when it's higher, we have A2- as the predominant species. So let's go over what we've learned. First of all, the fractional composition of diprotic acids is completely pH dependent. Secondly, if you want to figure out which of the three possible species predominates in a solution at a given pH, check out your two pKa's. Understanding the fractional composition of an acid is really important in understanding complex solution equilibria, and it's especially helpful in understanding carbonate chemistry in natural water systems. I hope this was helpful, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.